transecutes primary amenorrhea with absent axillary improving care. Testicular feminization or androgen receptor. Best clinical way to differentiate Fullerian vaginosis and PFS. Axillary improving care. They are absenting. Yes. Overall best way to differentiate Fullerian vaginosis. Primary amenorrhea with absent secondary sexual character. Primary amenorrhea with absent secondary sexual character. Does it? Primary amenorrhea with gynecorrhea. Craniofacial. Primary amenorrhea with bilateral inguinal hernia.
Upper 3/5 of vagina,
fused quarterly to form urogenital. And their fusion starts below. Means, pehle niche wala area fused hota hai, last fused hota hai. Aur ye dono fused kab ho jati hai? 12. Aur in dono ducts ke beech ki ye jo andar wali wall hai, ye wali. ये कब डिसअपीयर हो जाती है? एक नॉर्मल यूट्रस पर. अब हम एब्नॉर्मल इटिस पर क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम. पहली प्रॉब्लम, इफ दीज मिलेनियम डक्ट्स डोंट फ्यूज एट ऑल, दे रिमेन सेपरेट. दे आर ऑल सिंगल लाइन ऑफ पिक्चर. व्हाट इज कॉल्ड टू यूट्रस. कैन आई चेंज द पेज? Yes. Abnormal. What? If Fallopian ducts don't fuse at all, outcome is uterine dialysis, which is also called as double uterus. Double uterus, two uterus, two cervix. This is the only congenital malformation which has two vagina.
Septum.
if the examiner asks you to collimate that fuse, but their inner walls persist in some portion and disappear in some portion, what is the congenital malformation. If only one Mendelian duct, instead of two Mendelian ducts in embryological life, only one duct. Outcome is unicorn. Unicorn. This is also called banana shape. How many fallopian tubes will be?
One.
Very good. The fallopian tube develops from only one duct. Congenital malformation of uterus is septic. Overall, most common congenital malformation of uterus is septic. What is the problem with these congenital malformations? What do you think? What can be the problem? It is bicuspid, it is septic. What is happening? Is space only drinking? Space is? That is the septum. Most common malformation is space. So what will happen when a fertilized ovum grows? Can it grow properly? No. Because of reduced space. So it will abort. The most common complication of these malformations is abort. Another option A, first trimester abortion. Option B,
second trimester.
There is space inside, but once it grows, once it enlarges, MRI for soft tissues. Marvelous for soft tissues. But why should we spend 10,000 rupees just to diagnose a septic or a bifurcation? Because a three-dimensional transvaginal ultrasound can give almost similar information in 1,000. So most commonly used investigation is three-dimensional transvaginal. Everybody understands TBS? Transvaginal sonograph. Ultrasound can be done by two ways: transabdominal and transvaginal. So read the question carefully whether it is best or most complex. Management. Previously, we were doing HST, histocentrography, no need to write. Problem with HST, what is HST? Histocentrography. In histocentrography, we instill a radiopaque dye through vagina and we take the X-ray film after 30 seconds. Right? Through this radiopaque dye, we can see the spectrum of that. Problem with HST was, if it was uterine didentate, where there were two vagina, we could totally miss other stuff because our dye will enter to one side. Second thing, we have laparoscopy, a very good instrument. We can introduce laparoscope, but laparoscope will see exterior of uterus or interior of uterus. Laparoscope is introduced in peritoneal cavity, so it will see exterior. So can you see a septum by laparoscope? We have other modality also called camera of uterus, called hysteroscope. Hysteroscope can easily see interior of uterus, can see septum, but can it see exterior of uterus? This is why MRI can see everything best. Ultrasound can also see everything, but most commonly used because MRI is superior. Management is required. If there is history of habitual abortion. Habitual abortion is also called recurrent abortion. What are habitual or recurrent abortion? If there is history of more than three abortions, they are called recurrent abortion or habitual. More than three, we call them recurrent or habitual. If there is sequence of events in puberty. Before hierarchy, there is no spot. You can notice increase in arm respect. You can notice increase in arm respect. But first visible sign is hierarchy. Hierarchy is first visible sign.
Yeah.
responsible for secondary sex effects. So we want to stop this estrogen. How to stop estrogen? You are done with pharma. Here now, let's say. Anything. Analog. Antagonist. Anything. Antagonist can be given. Analog can be given. But if analog has to be given, how will you give analog? Continuous or first? Option A, first type. Option B, second. GNRS, don't know what it is. Physics can be a part. Kabajna can pass to a given. The body will endogenously the GNRS secret. कैसे होता है नॉर्मल जैसे कमरे में रूम फ्रेशनर लगा है हाइपोथैलेमस से जीएनआरएस निकला फिर डायरेक्ट होता फिर कुछ सेकंड बाद कुछ मिनट बाद फिर रिसीव व्हाट इज हैपनिंग एक्चुअली इनसाइड हाइपोथैलेमस इज सीक्रेटिंग जीएनआरएस इन पल्सेटाइज फैशन सो व्हाट्स हैपनिंग इंटरमिटेंटली रिसेप्टर्स एंड पिट्यूटरी गेट फ्री So other stuff is also acting stuff. If you give injection of CNRS, a bolus injection, a continuous injection, what will happen? This continuous CNRS will occupy all the receptors at pituitary. This is called competitive antagonism. This is called competitive antagonism. Pharmacological. Competitive antagonism. Because receptors are continuously occupied by exogenous GNRS, endogenous GNRS is not able to. So S2S2 is retarded. It's stopped. So best management here is continuous GNRS. Don't try just GNRS. And encircle the word continuous. Clear? मुझे बता देना जब भी टी ब्रेक लेना हो उससे मुझे 20 मिनट पहले बता देना क्योंकि उससे 20 मिनट पहले मैंने जो सुबह से अभी तक पढ़ाया है वो 20 मिनट्स में रिवाइज कराऊंगा मुझे उसकी जरूरत महसूस जब भी चाय का ब्रेक लेना हो उससे 20 मिनट पहले मुझे जरूर बता हमें कब लेना है चाय का ब्रेक 20 मिनट के बाद मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम विथ सीक्रेट जीएनआर टेस्ट फ्रॉम विथ सीक्रेट एफएसएच टेस्ट फ्रॉम ओवेरियन With secret, estradiol and both these estradiol and NVP give negative feedback to
FSH
and positive feedback to
LH.
Positive to
LH.
So levels of LH start driving it. Approximately 24 to 36 hours before ovulation, there is seven. This is called
LH.
Approximately 10 to 12 hours before peak event. That is peak in the day. How much time before?
10 to 12.
Minimum amount of estrogen required for ovulation?
75.
Every line in itself is good. What is another action of LH? Very good. LH leads to secretion of androgen from which cell?
Peak of cell.
What is the fate of these androgens?
Estrogen.
They are converted to
estrogen.
Enzyme involved in?
Aromatase.
Process called in?
Aromatization.
After ovulation, this ruptured follicle is called?
Corpus luteum.
It secretes how many hormones?
Four hormones.
Predominant is?
Progesterone.
Maximum activity of corpus luteum is on which post-ovulatory day?
Seven.
Or day 21 of cycle. After this, it starts giving negative feedback to?
FSH.
FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH. FSH Rupiah, Regent Lake.